Guys, what is up? Welcome back to another boat project video. Still doing demo work. We're going to be knocking out that transom board today, hopefully, and getting the rest of the excess aluminum cut out of it that we're not going to need in the future design of the boat. After that, it's going to be pretty much cleaning, cleaning, cleaning with the wire brush attachments.
Smile.
All right, guys. Going to do a quick recap of what we've done on the boat so far, and then a little bit of a Q&A here at the end. I have had a few questions come my way about this boat, and I'd like to address them before we get too far. As far as the recap goes, we've taken just about everything that was originally in this boat out. We've removed all the rotten wood, took out all the subfloors, front, middle, and back, cut out the console, removed all the nasty foam. We've cut most of the section of the rear bench out. We've cut a hole in the center bench, removed all the foam from it. We've removed the transom board, did a little bit of cutting on the back end there to get that out. But all in all, right now where we're at, it's just grinding and sanding and just getting all this nasty gunk off this boat. Like I said, I'd like to get it down to bare metal or as close as I possibly can. As far as my plans for this boat, I'm still kind of going back and forth. Until I know what needs to be fixed and, you know, what's good and what's not, pretty much, it's kind of leaving me in the dark as far as what I'm going to do as far as the layout goes. My plan right now, granted it'll probably change, but, you know, we're going to make casting deck up front, extend it all the way to the back of the center bench. So that'll be our casting deck. Then we'll have a main subfloor right here in the middle, and then of course we'll have this back compartment to house the gas tanks, the battery for the electronics, and, you know, bilge pumps, that sort of thing. As far as the live well goes, I'm still going back and forth on a portable live well. And the only reason I'm going back and forth is mainly because I'm not finding the kind of enclosure that I want to use for a live well without, you know, paying hundreds of dollars. I thought I had a lead on one at Lowe's, but they don't carry it anymore. The only thing that turns me off about the whole portable live well situation is in these tournaments that I fish, you have to have at least a 30 quart or bigger rolling cooler to take your fish to weigh in. Well, the thing about a portable live well is if I put one in, I won't be able to pull it out of the boat once it's, you know, got water and fish in it. There's no way. So I'm still left having to transfer those fish at the end of the day. But at the same time, it could be just as costly to buy two coolers, one for transport and one to convert into a live well, as it would to outfit this boat with its own live well, pumps, and all that good stuff. So like I said, it's something that I'm still throwing around. By all means, guys, comment down in the comment section below what you would do in this situation. Because in all honesty, not every time that I go fishing I need a live well, okay? Most times I go fishing, I don't necessarily need a live well. If I am collecting meat, I'm throwing it straight on ice half the time. So it's one of those things, like I said, it's going back and forth in my head. Now, the few questions that I have had on this boat are pretty generic, you know, year, make, model, that sort of thing. And I know I haven't exactly, you know, given y'all the rundown on this boat. This boat is a late 50s. I can't remember if it was 56 or 59, but it's a late 50s Duracraft. And if you watch the first demo video, I threw up a few pictures of what this boat used to look like or usually looks like. Like I said before, it was a pleasure craft. It didn't have no purpose other than throwing four people in this thing and just putting around the lake. That's all it was built for. As I've expressed before, somebody tried modifying this once before. I liked the idea that they had, but they executed a lot of these things very wrong. Especially with this back transom, most dangerous thing I've ever seen. So Duracraft, I really don't have a whole lot of experience. I know they're still in business. I know they still make aluminum rigs, but as far as how good they were around the late 60s, like I said, don't really know, just because you don't see a whole lot of these boats still out on the water. Another thing that we were able to do, we've already traded that motor out. I don't know if I've mentioned that before, but we've got the 25 horse Mariner sitting over here in the corner. Yes, it is a tiller. I'm not exactly sure the year on it. Once again, it was a straight trade. It's something to get us by for now. Like I said, I plan on getting a 40 or 50 horse tiller once the rest of the boat is finished and up to par. I'm not gonna sink $3,000 or $4,000 on a motor right now. One other thing I do wanna mention is, even though I had all the proper paperwork and this thing was actually legal till 2021 over in Oklahoma, in Arkansas, they've got a bunch of new laws regarding these old aluminum boats. And although I was able to get the trailer tag, no problem. The boat, it's going to be a little bit longer of a process. I've actually got to get with Arkansas Game and Fish, and they've actually got to register me an HID number for this boat. Now, no, it's not the whole identification number. That's a whole different ball of wax. The HID number is the serial number that's found on the transom of your boat on aluminum rigs built after like 1980, something like that. Anyway, obviously this thing, well before that mark, we're gonna have to do a little packet situation, and Arkansas Game and Fish is gonna issue me numbers for this boat, and then, you know, she'll be legal beagle. And I'm not throwing too much of a fit about it, mainly because, like I said, you know, we'll have a good year in this project, so everything will be on the up and up by the time this thing actually hits the water. You can guarantee that. All right, guys, I'm gonna go ahead and stop rambling now. Like I said, the only thing left with this boat is mainly cleaning. So I probably won't pick up again until it's actually time to pull it off the trailer and continue with that. Because like I said, I'm not going to bore y'all with a bunch of grinding and a bunch of sanding. Just know, like I said, I've got a couple of weeks worth of that ahead of me just to get this thing down to bare metal. I'd love to get a fishing video or two in for you guys in between that time. But with work schedule and weather right now, maybe not. But until next time, guys, you stay safe, stay outdoors.